Hi, this is Mohammad Rashid, and today we are going to see the parameter programming on Rockwell Automation Allen Bradley VFD. So before starting the programming, we can understand how we can use the button and what is the status of the LEDs. Okay, so number one, run and direction status. There is a LED over there that will show you the run and direction status. Same alphanumeric display. Display units, 4 number program status, 5 number fault status. If there any fault will come, there is a LED which will flashing red, indicates that the drive is faulted. Same potentiometer status, it means if you have selected the potentiometer from the drive, it will steady green. Okay, if you don't select, that light will become off. Same the start key status, if your drive is a start, it will steady green, indicates start key on integral keypad is active. Now we can check how you will use the buttons. There is a button that is escape. Escape button which will take you a one step back in the programming menu. Also you can cancel or change parameter value and exit program mode. There is a button that is select. If you whatever you want to select, that will select the parameter. There is an up and down button. If you change any one to, if you want to change any numbers, so that number can be changed by this up and down button. And the last one is the enter button. Whatever you have changed, if you want to store that value on the VFD, so you just press that enter, the value will stored. Okay, there is a potentiometer, and there is 3 more button, that is start, stop, and you change the reverse forward directions of the VFD, from the VFD to the motor. But you have to remember these potentiometer, start stop button, and the reverse forward button, you can activate and deactivate also from the parameter all these buttons. Okay, now we are going to see the parameter programming. Whenever you press the enter button, it will show you the groups. Okay, Now I am pressing a enter button, it's showing D001. This is the display group. Okay, that is the up and down button, T4 terminal block group, P4 parameter group, A4 advanced group, and C4 communication group. Okay, now if D001, if 1 is blinking, it means the VFD is giving you the option that you can change 1 or 2, 2 to 1, like this is. D002, it will show you the hertz, 27.0 hertz. D003, it will show you ampere, on what ampere your drive is running. D004, it will show you the volts, it means on what volt your motor or drive is running. So you can see D001 0.0 hertz, it means the drive is stopped, that's why it's showing you 0.0 hertz. Okay, when you will, if you want to go up, you just press up button. If you want to come back, press escape button. D003, it will show you the ampere, and the LED light is also on. See, the volt light has on. So this is the basic display group. In this group, you can only see the value. You can't edit, or you can't change, or you can't increase the speed. Now we can see basic program group. P101, motor NP volts. Okay. P101 is the parameter where you can put the volts which is written on your motor nameplate. It means in my motor it has written 415 volt, so I have given the 450 volt on parameter 101. Same P102, motor NP hertz, you can also find the hertz on your motor nameplate, 50-60 hertz approx. P103, motor overload current, it means this is also a parameter you can find on your motor nameplate. Whatever the ampere it was written on your motor nameplate, you have to give over here, P103. P104 is a minimum frequency, it means when your motor will start from zero, this is the minimum frequency. And P105 is a maximum frequency, it means the motor will reach up to 50 hertz if you have given 50 hertz maximum frequency. If you will give 60 hertz, it will go up to 60 hertz frequency. Okay, but you have to decide all this 50 and 60 hertz by your motor nameplate. Okay, P106 is a start source. By this parameter, you can give the start command to your drive. So, but in this P106, you have a 5 type of options how you want to start your drive. If you put 0 in P106, so the drive will start and stop by your drive switch, because on the drive, on the VFD, there is a start and stop switch button over there. So you can start, if you put 0, this will start and stop by your drive button. If you give 1, so it means 3 wire, you are giving the command from the outside of the drive. Okay, the maybe outside the push button or any relay command. Same 2 over here, the 2 wire, 3 is a 2 wire level sensor. Okay, the 4 2 wire high speed, and 5 is a communication port. It means if you want to put your drive, it will take the command by the communication. So you have to give P106 is 5. P107 is a stop mode, how you want to stop your drive. Default is 0, I have also taken 0 over here. Okay, P108 is a speed reference. It means the start and stop command you have given on P106, but P108, how you will increase the speed. It means the starter, after giving the start and stop command, you have to give the reference, speed reference, that how much speed you want to run your drive or your motor. So if you give the 0, you can increase or decrease the speed by the drive port. There is a potentiometer over there on the drive, and if you give 1, that you will use an internal frequency. If you give it 2, so you can add potentiometer outside of the drive and on the panel, and you can give the signal or speed from the panel. So 0 to 10 volt. If you want to give the signal 4 to 20 milliampere, it will also increase the speed. 4 preset frequency, and the 5 is communication frequency. It means if you want to give the speed by the communication, you have to give select 5. Acceleration is P109 is an acceleration time. It means when you give the start command, how much time the motor will take to reach his speed from 0 to given speed. Same deacceleration time, when you give the stop command, how much time it will take from running speed to zero speed. P111 is a motor overload retention, and P112 is a reset to default value. It means if you want to clean your VFD drive and you want to make its factory default, so if you have to give P112 to 1 and enter, it will become factory default. Okay, now we will see the parameter programming on our drive. P101, I have set 450 volt. P102, minimum maximum frequency. P103, 7.5 ampere. P104 is minimum frequency. P105, I have set maximum frequency 50 hertz. P106 is a start source command. Okay, P107 is a stop mode, and P108 is a speed reference. I have taken over at 3, it means 4 to 20 milliampere. P109 acceleration 5 hertz. P1010 deacceleration 3 seconds. And P1011 is 0. And P1012 default values is 0. Okay.